This example marks the beginning of our study of determining the area under a function bounded by the x-axis. And this is a major topic of integral calculus. And as long as a function is non-negative and continuous over a specific interval, we can represent the area under a curve as a definite integral, where the area is equal to the integral from a to b of f of x with respect to x, where f of x would be the function and the interval would be from a to b. So let's take a look at this example. S prime of t equals v of t equals 65, which means the derivative of the position function is equal to the velocity function, which is equal to 65. And this models the speed of a car traveling on a freeway where v of t is in miles per hour and t is the number of hours. We want to determine the area under the graph bounded by the x-axis on the interval from 0 to 2 and then interpret the results. So here we have the graph of our velocity function, v of t equals 65 in blue. And we want to determine the area under this curve bounded by the x-axis on the interval from 0 to 2. So we're trying to determine the area of this rectangular region here. So because this region is rectangular, we're not going to need any calculus techniques to determine this area. We'll use the area formula for a rectangle, which is length times width. So notice that our length here would be equal to 65, and our width on this interval would be equal to 2. But again, because this function is continuous and non-negative on this interval, we can represent the area as a definite integral. Let's go ahead and do that. The area would be equal to the definite integral from 0 to 2 of 65 with respect to x. And because this region is rectangular, the area would just be 65 times 2, which equals 130. So this definite integral, which represents this area, is equal to 130. So let's talk about what this means. We're multiplying the rate in miles per hour times the time in hours, which should remind us of the distance formula. Distance equals rate times time. So this 130 represents the total distance traveled from t equals 0 to t equals 2 over the first 2 hours. So in the next several lessons, we'll be determining ways to approximate this area if we can't use a geometric formula. And then we'll find a pretty exciting way to determine area under a function using antiderivatives once we discuss the fundamental theorem of calculus. But for now, we'll take a look at a couple more examples of determining area under a curve by using geometric formulas.